More incoming information. A juror has been dismissed from the sentencing trial of convicted cop killer Marco Topete. KCRA3's David Bienick live at the Yolo County Courthouse with why the juror was let go today. David?
Good afternoon, Walt. Yes, it was one of the most unusual moves so far in a trial that has simply been full of them. And it may be the deciding factor in whether Marco Topete gets life or death.
I cannot talk. Don't do that.
Juror number 11 walked out of the courthouse this morning after the judge granted her request to be dismissed from the jury deliberating Marco Topete's fate. In court, the juror, whose name has not been released, said that she was born and raised in Russia and sometimes has difficulty with her language skills. My English is limited. I cannot be that verbal, said the juror. I do not want to be an obstacle. District Attorney Jeff Reisig said dismissing the juror was, quote, the safest approach. But defense attorney Dwight Samuel said, quote, I think a ruling like this would make a sham of this jury. Judge Paul Richardson reminded both sides they had allowed this juror to make it through the selection process. She sat through nearly 3 months of testimony and voted last month to convict Marco Topete of first-degree murder. I'm very mindful of the minefield that is here, said the judge. After the juror was dismissed, a court clerk pulled the name of an alternate from a basket. The judge then ordered the jury to start its deliberations over again from the very start. And in questioning this dismissed juror this morning, the judge was very careful not to let her give any indication of which way she or the other jurors are leaning in their decision about whether or not Marco Topete should face the death penalty. The new jury began its deliberations at exactly 10:16. Live in Woodland, David Bienick, KCRA3 reports.
David, how did the other jurors react to this?
Well, the other jurors were not in the courtroom when the decision was announced, but I saw when this dismissed juror left the courtroom out in the hall, she got some hugs and some well wishes from the other jurors. They will probably never see each other again. The dismissed juror says she does not want to be notified when a verdict is reached.
So, David, a final question. This juror has been involved with this trial all this time, and now that it's into the sentencing, the juror then claims that there's some type of a language issue?
Yeah, that's really what makes this so unusual. Obviously, all parties have been aware of this since this juror was selected back in March, and she sat through, again, 3 months of testimony. She was part of that deliberations that convicted Marco Topete, but something about this deliberating about his sentence has made her come forward now and saying she just can't do it.
David Bienick with the very latest. David, thank you.